Welcome learners, I am Divya Nath. Today we are going to discuss about Module 4, Lesson 8, Measures of Central Tendency, Part 2. In this module, we are going to discuss about combined mean and its computation. Then we are going to discuss about concept of weighted arithmetic mean and its computation. After this, we are going to discuss about concept of median and its computation in case of individual, discrete and continuous series. Let's start with the class. So, combined mean. When we are able to compute combined mean? If a series of n observations consists of two components, then we are able to compute combined mean. Now, in this case, we are going to have two observations, n1, n2, and there will be two means given to us for the two components, mean of 1, mean of 2 respectively. Then the combined mean can be calculated as n1 into mean of first plus n2 mean of 2 divided by total number of observation of the two components, that is n1 and n2. Let's see with the help of an example what we have learned. The average marks of three batches of students having 70, 50 and 30 students respectively. So here we have been given number of observations n1 70, n2 50, n3 30 and their means are being given as 50, 55 and 45. Now the question tells, find the average marks of all the 150 students taken together. So here we have got number of observations as 70, 50, 30. Mean is given to us as 50, 55 and 45. In this case, the combined mean formula will be written as mean 1 for first compartment, second component and the third component. N1 mean of 1 plus N2 mean of 2 plus N3 mean of 3 divided by total number of observations, that is 70 into 50 plus 50 into 55 plus 30 into 45 divided by total number of observation, that is 70 plus 50 plus 30, that comes to 7600 divided by 150, that comes to 50.67 marks. So we have learned how to compute combined mean. Now we can discuss about weighted mean. Now when we are going to compute weighted mean? We are going to compute weighted mean when importance or significance is to be given to some of the items. Then we compute weighted mean. Now weighted mean average is the mean of weighted items. Let's see what are the steps by which we can calculate weighted mean. Very first, weights are indicated by W. Then the items are multiplied by their corresponding weights W. So we will get WX and then we are going to add up to get sum of, that is summation WX. After this, we are going to divide this summation of WX by the sum of the weights. So we get the formula, weighted mean is equals to sum of WX divided by sum of W. Now let students take an example to compute weighted mean. In this particular question, as you can see, it is being given, calculate weighted mean of the following data. Marks and their weights have been given. So let's see how we are going to solve it. Now here we are going to make one more column of WX. We will multiply these weights with the respective marks. Now marks are X variables. So WX will be the next column. We are going to start with W very first, 2 into 81 that gives 162. Next 3 into 76 gives us 228. Likewise 6 into 74 gives us 444. Then 7 into 58 gives us 406. 3 into 70 gives us 210 and then 7 into 73 gives us 511. Now students, we are going to sum up WX column and we get 1961. Likewise, we are going to sum up W column, that means weight sum, that is 28. Now students, always write the formula, because if you are not writing the formula, you are not going to get marks for the formula. The formula is weighted mean is equals to sum of WX divided by sum of W. Now put the value, we get 1961 divided by 28, that is 70.04 marks. So students, we have learned how to compute weighted mean. After this, we can discuss about median. Now what is median? Median is the positional value that divides the series into two equal parts. Now how does it divide? It divides in such a way that half of the items lie above this value and the remaining half lie below this value. Now according to one of the author, the definition is the median is that value of the variable which divides the group into two equal parts. One part comprising all values greater than the median value and the other part comprising all the values smaller than the median value. So students, we have learned the definition as given by Corner. Now let's discuss how we are going to compute median. Now when we talk about the methods of computing median, median can be calculated for individual series, it can be calculated for discrete series, and it can be calculated for continuous series. Let's see the steps how we are going to compute median in case of individual series. Now the very first step when you are going to compute median is that you need to arrange the data. Either you can arrange the data in ascending order or descending order. Now once you have done the arrangement of the data, add up the number of items indicated by n. So we must know the total number of items. So we are going to count and it is denoted by n. Then find out the median items as n plus 1 by 2th item. Once we have done this, then median is equals to size of n plus 1 by 2th item. If n of the series happens to be odd number, then what we are going to do? That is not divisible by 2. It is easier to find out the median with the help of the following formula, that is n plus 1 by 2. We'll get the item value and we can easily find the median value. But student, what happens when the number of observation comes to even? In such a case, first we are going to compute n plus 1 by 2th item. So suppose it gives us 2.5th item. What we are going to do to find out the median value? We are going to do first write down the value of the second item, then add up the value of the third item and then divide it by 2. Hence, as you can see in this example also, the size of 2.5th item, what we have done, the size of the second item plus the size of the third item divided by 2. It gives us 10 plus 12 by 2, that is 22 by 2 comes to 11. Hence, we have computed median. So students, we have learned that median can be calculated in both the cases when the number of observation is odd as well as even. Now let's take an example to see whether we have learned or not how to compute median. Now in this particular question, the following series shows marks in economics of 11 students of class 11. Find the median marks. So marks have been given. The very first step, students, we have to arrange the data in ascending or descending order. So in this particular, we have already aligned up all the data as per ascending order. So marks have been arranged in ascending order. Very first. Here the number of observation is odd. So there is no problem as such. 11 plus 1 by 2th item. Why? Because median size is equals to n plus 1 by 2th item. 11 plus 1 by 2th item gives 6th item. Now the next step, locate the 6th value in the marks. The 6th value goes with 21 marks. So our median is 21 marks. So this is how we have computed median in case of individual series. First, we have arranged the data in ascending order. Then we have put the formula, that is median is equals to size of n plus 1 by 2th item. Then we have written the value of n, the total number of observation is 11 over here, 11 plus 1 by 2th item. We got 6th item, the size of 6th item, we have located in the marks and it is 21 marks. Now we can do it in descending order also. The marks have been arranged in descending order. Again the formula remains the same. Median is equals to size of n plus 1 by 2th item, n over here is 11, 11 plus 1 by 2th item gives you 6th item. If we locate in the marks, again it is 21 marks. So students, we have learned how to compute median in case where the observation is odd. Now let's see when the observation is even, how we are going to compute it. Suppose in this particular question, the following series shows marks in economics of 10 students of class 11, find the median marks. Now here the number of observation is 10. It has changed from 11 to 10. So we are saying the number of observation is even. Now in this particular case, the very first step goes the same. We are going to arrange the data in ascending order. So we have arranged the data in ascending order. Then we have written the formula. Again the same formula. Median is equals to size of n plus 1 by 2th item. Now over here n has changed from 11 to 10. So put the value of 10. 10 plus 1 by 2th item gives 5.5th item. Now as you can see, I have highlighted the 5th and the 6th value. Over here what we are going to do? We are going to write 5th value plus 6th value divided by 2. What is the 5th value? That is 21. What is the 6th value? That is 32. And then we are going to divide it by 2. Hence our median value is 26.5 marks. So students, you have also learned how to calculate median in case of individual series where the number of observation is even. Now students, we can calculate median in case of discrete series. Let's see what are the steps, what steps we should take while we are computing median through discrete series. Very first, the step remains the same. You need to arrange the data. Normally we arrange the data in ascending order. But while you are arranging the data, you have to be very careful. Why? Because whenever you are moving x, the frequencies must move along with the value of x. First step, we have arranged the data. Next step, we have to make one column for cumulative frequency. Step third, write the formula for the median. It remains the same for individual series. Median is equals to size of n plus 1 by 2th item. Now you have computed the value, the item. Now you are going to look this item value in the cumulative series. And the value which corresponds to the x gives you the median value. In the step 4, what we have done, whatever the item value we have got in the third step, we have looked into cumulative frequency. And in front of cumulative frequency, the variable x becomes your median. So let's see, we have learned it or not. The question is, calculate median from the following data. Marks 45, 55, 25, 35, 5 and 15. We can easily see the data is not arranged. So we need to arrange the data, the very first step. Let's see how we have done. Marks in an ascending order. So we have arranged the marks in ascending order and the respective frequencies have moved along. So 5, 15, 25, 35, 45 and 55, the marks are there. Now the first step we have done, we have arranged the data in ascending order. The second step, cumulative frequency. We have made one more column for the cumulative frequency, that is 10, 10 plus 20, 30. 30 plus 30 comes to 60, 60 plus 50 comes to 110, 110 plus 40 comes to 150, 150 plus 30 comes to 180. So we have done the cumulative frequencies. Now students, go for a cross check over here. We have to total the sum of frequency also. So while we get the sum of frequency, it should be also 180. It ensures that whatever we have computed in CF is right. Now after this, write the formula. Median is equals to size of n plus 1 by 2th item. Over here, the number of observation would be sum of frequency, that is 180. So we are going to put the value of 180 in this formula. 180 plus 1 by 2th item. We get 90.5 item. Now this value we are going to locate in cumulative frequency. As you can see, I have highlighted the whole row. We find this 90.5th item in 110. Now just see, in case the cumulative frequency which includes 90.5th item is 110, median would be 35 corresponding to this cumulative frequency. That is, median over here comes to 35 marks. So students, we have learned how to compute median in case of discrete series in this way. Now we can discuss about how we can compute median in case of continuous series. Now in this, the step 1 remains same. You need to arrange the data. Along with that, you need to compute cumulative frequencies. After that, once you have computed cumulative frequencies, you need to ascertain n by 2th item. Now what value will this give? It gives the median class. It tells about median class. So step 1, by arranging the data in ascending order, find out cumulative frequencies. Step 2, ascertain n by 2th item. Step 3, find out the cumulative frequency which includes n by 2th item and corresponding class frequency. The corresponding class of this cumulative frequency is called the median class. Students, if you do remember in the previous question, in cumulative frequency we got the median answer, but in this case we are getting the median class. That's the difference over here. In the previous question we have done n plus 1 by 2th item, but over here in continuous series we are doing it n by 2th item. So this is the difference you must note. So again I am repeating the steps. First, arrange the data. Calculate cumulative frequencies. Step 2, ascertain n by 2th item. Step 3, locate this n by 2th item in cumulative frequency, and the corresponding class will get the median class. Now the formula to compute median is, median is equals to lower limit plus n by 2th item minus cumulative frequency. Now this cumulative frequency is of preceding class, the previous class, divided by the frequency of the median class into I. I shows the class interval gap. Let's see with the help of the question how we are going to compute median in case of continuous series. Now in this particular question, as you can see, weekly expenditure is being given to us, 0 to 10, 10 to 20, 20 to 30, 30 to 40, 40 to 50. Step 1, arrange the data in ascending order. It is already being done, so we don't need to. Again, along with that, we need to compute cumulative frequency also. So we have made one more column for the cumulative frequency. So it would be 14. 14 plus 23, that comes to 37. 37 plus 27, that comes to 64. 64 plus 21 comes to 85. 85 plus 15 comes to 100. And students, we need to cross check. The sum of the frequency must also be 100. So once we have computed cumulative frequency, we will ascertain the value of n by 2th item. Over here, n is the total number of observation, that comes to 100. 100 divided by 2th item comes to 50th item. Now we are going to locate this 50th item in the cumulative frequency. It comes into 64. So our median class is 20 to 30. And the frequency is 27. Preceding class cumulative frequency is 37. Once again students, we have located the value of 50th item in cumulative frequency. In 64, we have got this value. Now, in this, we can see that weekly expenditure 20 to 30 is being given to us. So, this will become our median class. The frequency would be 27. The preceding class cumulative frequency is 37. Now, students, write the formula first. The formula goes, median is equals to lower limit plus n by 2 minus CF upon F into I. We will put the value. L over here is lower limit of the median class, that is 20. So, we have written 20 plus. Then comes n by 2, it is 50. So, we have written 50 minus CF. CF is 37 minus 37 divided by frequency of the median class, that is 27. So, we have put the value 27 over here. And the class interval gap, 20 to 30 between the gap is 10, we have multiplied with 10. So, we get the value as shown, rupees 24.815. So, this is our median value. So, students, we have learned how to compute median in case of continuous series. We now know that we need to arrange the data over here also. So, let's see if the question turns from continuous series to inclusive series, how we are going to compute median. We all know in frequency distribution there is inclusive series, there is unequal class interval series, there is cumulative series. So, in such a cases, how we are going to compute median? Students, we must convert all these different series into exclusive series. Once we have converted this into exclusive series, then we can easily compute median. In this particular case, I have taken a question of inclusive series. The marks have been given as 46 to 50, 41 to 45, 36 to 40, 31 to 35, 26 to 30, 21 to 25, 16 to 20 and 11 to 15. So, here the marks is such that it is making an inclusive series. Now, the first step, we need to see that data is arranged in ascending order. And the second step is that we need to convert this inclusive series into exclusive. How we are going to do? Very first, as you can see from the last class interval, we're going to see because we have to arrange in ascending order, that is 11 to 15. This will be our first class now because we are arranging the data in ascending order. So, the lower limit is 11, the upper limit is 15. The next would be 16 to 20. The gap between the two limits is 1. Limits are 2. 1 divided by 2 comes 0.5. Now, this 0.5 would be subtracted from lower limit. So, what we have done, 11 minus 0.5 comes to 10.5, 15 plus 0.5 comes to 15.5. Likewise, for 16 to 20, 16 minus 0.5 that comes to 15.5, 20 plus 0.5 that comes to 20.5. We have done for the whole class intervals. Now, let's see the students. We have arranged the data in ascending order. Very first thing, we have converted this inclusive series into exclusive series. Now, this question is normal. We have done into exclusive series. We can easily find out the median value. As per the normal question, very first step, we have already done, arrange the data in ascending order. We have done the data, it is arranged in ascending order. Now, the next step is, we have to make a column for cumulative frequency. Now, it is 7. 7 plus 10 comes to 17, 17 plus 13 comes to 30, 30 plus 26 comes to 56, 56 plus 35 comes to 91, 91 plus 22 comes to 113, 113 plus 11 comes to 124, 124 plus 5 comes to 129. And see over here, we have cross-checked also. The sum of the frequency is also 129. So, we have done absolutely right. Now, once we have arranged the data in exclusive form, in exclusive series, and we have computed cumulative frequency, we can easily compute median by putting the formula. Now, in this, very first, we'll calculate median class, that would be size of n by 2th item. N over here is 129 divided by 2 item, that comes to 64.5th item. As you can see, the median class for this is 30.5 to 35.5. Now, we will write the formula. Median is equals to lower limit plus n by 2 minus Cf upon F into I. Over here, the lower limit is 30.5. The previous class cumulative frequency is 56. The frequency of the class is 35 and the class interval gap is of 5. So, putting the value we get 30.5 plus 64.5 minus 56 divided by 35 into 5. We get 30.5 plus 1.2, that comes to 31.7 marks. So, students, we have learned that median can be computed in other frequency distribution also, but for that they must be first converted into exclusive series. Once we have computed into exclusive series, we can easily compute median. So here the note goes, in case of mid value and cumulative series, we need to convert into exclusive series. And why it is being done? Because we need lower limit in the formula, which must represent continuous series. I hope, students, you have learned how to compute median in case of individual series, in case of discrete series, in case of continuous series, as well as other type of series in the frequency distribution. So, let's see if the missing value is being given. Now, how we are going to compute median? Let's read the question, because it's a good question. Here, two frequencies are being missing. Find the missing frequency in the following distribution. If n is 100 and median is 30. The very first check, the data must be arranged in ascending order. Here the data is already arranged in ascending order. The next step, we can see the total number of observation is given as 100, whereas the median value is 30. We all know the rules for exclusive series. We have already learned in the previous chapter. So, 20 to 30, the value of 30 never includes in it upper limit in case of exclusive series, whereas it will be included in the next lower limit. So, the median class, the identification of the median class comes from the median value. So, median is given 30. So, 30 will be included in the class of 30 to 40. Therefore, the class frequency comes 30. Let's see how we are going to compute the missing frequencies in this case. The very first step, we have already seen the data is already arranged in ascending order. The next step, we are going to compute cumulative frequency. For the first frequency which is being missing, we have denoted as F1. For the next frequency which is being missing, it is denoted as F2. So, 10 cumulative frequency, the next is 10 plus F1, then 10 plus F1 plus 25 comes to 35 plus F1, then 35 plus F1 plus 30 gives 65 plus F1, then 65 plus F1 plus F2, next 65 plus F1 plus F2 plus 10 comes to 75 plus F1 plus F2. That means the total sum of observations, total sum of students comes to 75 plus F1 plus F2. We all know that in this particular question, the total number of frequencies being given as 100. So, the first equation is being formed, that is 75 plus F1 plus F2 is equals to 100. Now, from this what we get? F1 plus F2 is equals to 25. Why? Because 100 minus 75 comes to 25. Now, we will write the formula for the median. We know median formula is M is equals to L plus N by 2 minus Cf upon F into I. The median value is already given to us. We are substituting that value, that is 30. Lower limit we can see is 30, because the median class is 30 to 40. So, the lower limit is also 30, that comes to 30 plus n by 2. It is 50th item, n means 100 divided by 2 comes to 50th minus Cf. In the question, you can see that for this particular class, the previous cumulative frequency is 35 plus F1. Then the frequency for the particular class is 30 into 10. 10 is the class interval gap. So, over here when we find the value, we get F1 as 15. Now, what we are going to do? We are going to substitute the value of F1 in the equation of F1 plus F2 is equals to 25. Hence, we get as F2 is equals to 10. So, students, we have learned how to compute median in case of missing frequency also. Students, I think you have learned enough for the class of median, combined mean and weighted mean. I hope you have enjoyed the class. Thank you.